Getting a flat while out on a ride is never fun, but it doesn't have to end your day. Today I will show you how to change the rear tire of a hub drive e-bike. I'm working on our Baku Flatlander, but this process should be pretty similar for any e-bike with a rear hub drive. Changing a flat on a wheel with a motor takes a little bit of extra care when compared to a standard wheel, but it's not difficult. The things you'll need to complete this repair include a new tube or a patch kit to repair the old tube. I always have a knife because sometimes there's zip ties you have to cut through. You'll need a wrench to remove the bolts. I keep a crescent wrench in my pack because it's versatile. Tire levers can definitely be helpful. Sometimes it's hard to take the tire on and off the rim. And whenever you're doing fixes out in the field, you need a good attitude. So getting into the repair, the first thing that I do is turn the bike upside down. When I do this, I'm careful with the screen or anything else that might end up on the ground, but this is the best way to do it if you don't have a stand. The next step is to put the bike in ninth gear, or the smallest diameter cog, the one farthest out from the wheel. This makes the wheel much easier to get back in at the end, and it also makes the wheel a little bit easier to get out. With the bike in ninth gear, I then look at the wire that runs to the motor and see how I'm gonna disconnect that to fully remove the wheel. On this bike, you just need to cut a zip tie and then pull it apart. With the wire disconnected, I then use the crescent wrench to loosen the bolts that keep the wheel onto the rear dropouts. On this bike, there is a derailleur guard, which is great for the durability of the bike. It can make it a little hard to take that bolt off, but it's still possible. If I can do it, you can do it. And after that, with both the bolts loosened, you don't have to take them fully off. You can remove the wheel. Removing the wheel, sometimes you kind of need to hold the derailleur down and shimmy it out. Just be gentle, you don't want to hurt your derailleur in the process. But with the wheel removed, you can then move on to the next step, getting the tire off. So sometimes you're gonna have to break the bead, so just move your hand along the sidewall and get the bead off of the rim. And with that done, you can take off the tire and the tube. Sometimes it is helpful to have tire levers to do this. This will give you some mechanical advantage if the tire is really tight against the rim. When you do have the tire and the tube removed, I fully inspect the rim and the tire. If you have a tire liner, you should also inspect that. The reason to do this is because it's good to determine how you got the flat. If it's because you had some thorn or debris in your tire, you're gonna wanna find that and of course remove it so that it doesn't happen again. If it's a pinch flat or something like that, that's still good to know. Just means you need to be a little bit more careful when you do put the tube in. So once you've fully inspected your tire and your rim and determined that they're good to go, you're gonna need a new tube or to patch your old tube. I usually out in the field have a spare tube so that I don't have to worry about patching when I'm out there, and it gets me going a little bit more quickly. Then I like to put a little bit of air in my new tube. This makes it easier for me to work with because then it's not completely limp. Then with my tube somewhat inflated, I put that to the side and put one side of my tire onto the rim. And I can usually do this by hand, but sometimes a tire lever will help get it fully on. With one half of the tire on the rim, I then put the tube in and make sure that the valve goes into the valve hole in the rim. And then I put the other side of the tire on, being sure to be careful and not pinch the tube anywhere. With that on nicely, I go ahead and pump up the tube to the correct PSI. With the hand pump out in the field, this can take a second, but just be patient and get to that correct PSI that you want to be at. You don't want to go too low and get another flat. With it pumped up, you should make sure too that the tire is seated correctly, and you can just look along the sidewall of the tire and make sure that you can see that line all the way around the rim. At this point, you're ready to reinstall the wheel onto the bike. So I just hold the derailleur, just be a bit gentle here. You shouldn't have to force it. It should go in relatively nicely, but you might have to shimmy it a bit and get it nice into those dropouts. So then with the wheel reinstalled, I just like to quickly visually inspect and make sure it all looks good to go. Once it looks good, I go ahead and tighten those bolts on either side down. You're gonna wanna make sure that these are nice and tight. With the bolts tightened down, just go ahead and replug the wire. And if you do have a zip tie, you can throw another zip tie on there to make sure that the wire stays out of the way. Then just shift the bike back down to a lower gear so that you don't have to start in ninth. And that's really all there is to it. After that, just carefully flip the bike back over and you're good to get riding again. So as you can see, it's a pretty straightforward process. If you have the right tools, it's not a big deal. Thanks for watching. Let us know if you have any other questions in the comments below, and you can also reach us at baku.com.